statements, I call the member for Rockdale.
Oh, Mr. Speaker, I rise today to pay tribute to the Rockdale Rangers Rugby Union Club, a fantastic juniors club in my electorate. The Rockdale Rugby Union Club has been serving Rockdale for more than 60 years and over that period catering to a wide range of teams and serving as a place for the rugby union community to come together in St George. This long and proud history includes one memorable season where I played under 10s at the age of 8. That was my first season of competition rugby union, Mr. Speaker, and I had signed up with my older brother Bill and my cousin Chip and George. And I can certainly say that at that age, an extra year makes a big difference in contact sport. I wish I could tell the House that it was a good year for Rockdale rugby, but I'm sad to say, Mr. Speaker, it was a terrible year for the under-10s. I think we struggled to muster up an odd cocktail of 15 players every weekend, and we lost to the fabulous sides of the eastern suburbs such as Matraville every week, 88-0, 66-0, 55-0. The only way we slowed down the score was to walk slow to kick off after a try. But even more shamefully, Speaker, we hadn't scored a try for the whole year, and on the last game of the year, I got across the line and knocked the ball on, and the whole crowd was so jubilant. We scored the first try, thinking we'd scored the first try of the year. The referee awarded it, Mr. Speaker. He awarded it on the basis that I didn't think he wanted to let the rest of the crowd down afterwards. But, Mr. Speaker, thankfully, Rockdale Rugby Union is doing much better these days with a fantastic list of achievements by their teams in the 2017 season, including the under-6s coming runners-up in the Southern Districts Minis Gala Day, the under-7s winning the Southern Districts Minis Gala Day, the under-8s had an incredible season winning the Southern Districts Minis Gala Day, the Harbour Harlequins Cup, the Oatley Gala Day, the Canberra 7s and coming runners-up in the King of the Hills, the under-9s winning the Canberra 7s in their age group and playing up to the under-10s, playing up in the City Juniors Rugby Union Friday night competition. The under-10s winning the City Junior Rugby Union Friday night competition and the Canberra 7s. And the under-11s winning the Sydney Junior Rugby Union Friday night competition and the Sunday competition A division. Wow. The under-12s winning the Sydney Junior Rugby Union Friday night competition and making the semi-final in the Canberra 7s. Furthermore, a large number of players were selected for the Southern District's representative team this year as well as last year. Mr. Speaker, for a small local club, without the heavyweight sponsors which support many of the larger junior rugby union clubs, the Rockdale Rangers truly punch above their weight. This is, of course, only possible thanks to the dedicated contribution of a great team of volunteers. And I'd like to formally acknowledge club president Niraj Chand, vice president Chris Mitchell, treasurer Sheila Mitchell, and secretary Michelle Sullivan. The executive, along with all the other parents, coaches and so on, have built a strong culture at the club, holding great social and rugby events and building a real sense of club spirit. Mr. Speaker, part of the recent success of the Rockdale Rugby Union Club is built of a strong sense of duty to our local community, supporting families from all cultural and socio-economic backgrounds. As far as I'm aware, Rockdale Rugby Union are the only juniors club in New South Wales that offers free registration, and they place a very strong emphasis on developing their players while maintaining at the heart of what they do a commitment to their players, having fun and enjoying themselves in a safe environment. Mr. Speaker, sport is so important to the development of our young people, and while it is fantastic to see the growth of football, which is of course hugely popular in my community, it is sometimes nice to see other sports remaining available. And particularly to see that Rockdale Rugby are performing more than a little bit better than we were when I was a kid. The benefits of children's sport 45 years ago are not just felt in terms of promoting physical activity, but they teach our young people teamwork and help build problem-solving skills and have strong flow-on effects in education. Mr. Speaker, I am so proud to support the Rockdale Rugby Union Club and look forward to their continuing strong performance and expansion.